in a little tent. Oh, and just like the river I've been running.
I was born in Tuckahoe, near Hillsboro, and about 12 miles from Easton, in Talbot County, Maryland. I have no accurate knowledge of my age, never having seen any authentic record containing it. I do not remember to have ever met a slave who could tell of his birthday. They seldom come nearer to it than planting time, harvest time, cherry time, springtime, or fall time. The white children could tell their ages. I could not tell why I ought to be deprived of the same privilege. The nearest estimate I can give makes me now between 27 and 28 years of age. The first few years of my life were spent on Colonel Lloyd's plantation. Years after that, I spent 7 years of my life living with the Alls. During this time, I succeeded in learning to read and write.
Now, what's that word, Frederick?
I believe it to be cattle, ma'am.
That's correct, Frederick. Good job.
Thank you, ma'am.
What do you think you're doing?
Well, I'm teaching Frederick how to read.
You don't need to be teaching him that stuff for what he'll be doing.
Slavery soon proved its ability to divest her of the heavenly qualities that she possessed when we first met. Under its influence, the tender heart became stone, and a lamb-like disposition gave way to one of tiger-like fierceness. Since my former teacher had refused to teach me, I had to get help from kids in the neighborhood who already knew how to read.
Hey boys, I bet I can write as well as you.
I don't believe you. We'll see you try.
Eat that.
I got a good many lessons in writing, which it's quite possible I should never have gotten in any other way. During this time, my copybook was the brick wall and pavement. My pen and ink was a lump of chalk. When I was about 15, I went to live with Mr. Colgan. I was sent there so that I could be broken.
Hi boys, I'm Frederick Douglass. I'm here at Mr. Colgan's farm.
Hi, Frederick, I'm Hughes.
My name's Bill. Nice to meet you. You better be careful with those oxen. They're very dangerous. And Mr. Colby will whip you if he finds out you ain't doing your job.
I'll be careful with that. Now, where do I sleep? You can lay down here if you want to. I appreciate it. Mr. Colby, the oxen got loose and broke the gate. I apologize.
Go back to the woods. I'll teach you to trifle away my time and break my gates. Get down.
I told you to be careful out there, Frederick.
I know, Bill, but I just couldn't handle it.
One good thing about Mr. Colby is he works in the fields with us.
That's a fast use. Mr. Colby does that so he crawls through the cornfields and catch us slaves resting up on them hot days. That's why they call him a snake.
I'm alright, fellas. I just had to be more careful next time.
One night, after escaping from Mr. Colby's, after he had beat me mercilessly, I fell in with Sandy Jenkins. He invited me over and I told him my circumstances. I went home with him and talked the whole matter over and got his advice.
You must go back to Mr. Covey, but before you do, you have to go into the woods with me and find a certain route. If you find this route, it will make it impossible for Mr. Covey or any other white man to whip me.
From there on, he never laid the weight of his finger upon me in anger. Then one day, I decided to escape from slavery, but will not describe the exact means of the escape, because I did not want to give slaveholders any information that would help them prevent other slaves from escaping to the North.